I'm Dr. Elizabeth Frank, an associate professor of pathology at the University of Utah School of Medicine and medical director of chemistry at ARUP Laboratories in Salt Lake City. My topic today is evaluation of nephrolithiasis. In this presentation, I'll discuss laboratory testing for evaluation of renal calculi and assessment of stone risk, a measure of an individual's tendency to form kidney stones based on urine composition. Kidney stones, or renal calculi, are concretions found in the renal pelvis, ureter, or bladder. They are formed of substances dissolved in the urine at sufficient concentration to precipitate out of solution under certain conditions. Nutrition and environmental factors, as well as genetics and anatomical abnormalities, contribute to kidney stone formation. Kidney stones are rather common in the adult population, and several professional organizations have published evidence-based guidelines for evaluation and treatment of the disease. Typically, medical and dietary history is assessed, and testing to include urinalysis, blood chemistry, and determination of calculus composition is advised. Additional testing for patients with stones composed of calcium or possible metabolic disease, cystinuria, is recommended. Evaluation of 24-hour urine collections for urinary excretion is used to identify systemic and renal abnormalities that predispose a patient to recurrent nephrolithiasis. Specimens, that is urine, for this testing should be collected while the patient is pursuing his usual diet and lifestyle at a time remote from stone incidents or a stone episode. Routine urinalysis and cystine testing can be performed on random urine collections. Urine culture is performed to identify stones associated with urinary tract infections. These stones, magnesium ammonium phosphate, or Struvite, are formed as a consequence of infection with urease-producing organisms and are associated with high urine pH. Testing to evaluate excretion in 24-hour urine collections includes measurement of urine volume and pH and quantitation of components known to promote kidney stone formation, that is calcium, oxalate, uric acid, and sodium, as well as components that inhibit calculus formation, such as citrate. Creatinine excretion is determined as a measure of the completeness of the collection. Kidney stones that are passed in the urine or surgically removed should be analyzed to determine their chemical composition. Results for stone analysis include mass or weight, quantity of the stones or fragments, and a description of the gross calculus in addition to the composition of the stone material. Some laboratories offer a photograph of the stone. Although a picture is not necessary for effective treatment, it can be meaningful for the healthcare provider to share with the patient and is useful in the case of unusual stone components or artifacts. At ARUP Laboratories, we use FTIR, or Fourier Transform Infrared Spectroscopy, to determine calculus composition. In this technique, the stone is crushed and ground with salt, then subjected to infrared radiation. Absorption of the radiation causes molecules and compounds, stone components in this case, to vibrate in characteristic, recognizable ways that can be detected, recorded, and analyzed to determine the composition of the stone. Laboratory staff persons analyze the spectra produced to determine the components present in the stone material. We use an algorithm to identify and confirm the chemical composition. Prediction of risk for formation of stones or stone recurrence involves testing urine specimens for components known to promote or inhibit precipitation of particular calculi. Low urine volume produces a concentrated urine and promotes the formation of stones. Low pH of urine is associated with the formation of uric acid stones. High urine pH is often associated with formation of calcium phosphate stones. Calcium, oxalate, sodium, and sulfate promote formation of calcium oxalate and calcium phosphate calculi, whereas citric acid and magnesium inhibit precipitation of calculi. Several tests are available to evaluate a patient's risk of forming stones. Assessment of calculi risk can be performed on a 24-hour urine collection. A supersaturation profile provides additional information by giving a relative saturation of particular stone components and a calculated measure of risk of formation of particular stones. You can find additional information on testing for calculi analysis and stone risk assessment on our website at aruplab.com.